Do you know that you are a billionaire? Yes, you heard right. You have more than 15 billion transistors in your phone. Hey billionaires, today we are talking about one of the greatest technological inventions of all time, the transistor. So, let's go. The transistor is a device that regulates current or voltage flow and acts as a switcher gate for electronic signals. The transistor changes when a certain amount of current or voltage is applied to it, and the action is very much similar to how a switch operates in terms of when it turns on and off. Transistors have a limited number of on and off states, so they can be used to create more complex circuit functions by combining where there are transistors in a circuit. A semiconductor is made of three things: a piece of silicon, a metal contact, and a little bit of impurity material. The impurity material is often boron, phosphorus, or gallium. These atoms have one less or one more electron than silicon. Transistors are semiconductor devices that have three terminals. These are known as the base, emitter, and collector. By combining these three parts, you get a harmonious device that controls electrical signals, which we call a transistor. I will explain you everything, don't worry. The transistor base is the part of a transistor that provides an electrical connection between the emitter and collector. The transistor base is of semiconducting material, either silicon or germanium. The size of the base region of a transistor determines how many emitter and collector regions can be formed on the same slice or wafer of semiconductor material. The more base area there is, the greater number of possible combinations between emitter and collector regions. The emitter is the other electrode in a transistor that receives current. It forms one side of the PN junction. The emitter is exposed to the air, but it must be insulated so that it does not get exposed to rain or other moistures, which could trigger corrosion. The emitter is always connected in forward biased with respect to the base, so that it supplies the majority charge carrier to the base. The section which collects the major portion of the majority charge carrier supplied by the emitter is called a collector. The collector base junction is always in reverse bias. Its main function is to remove the majority charges from its junction with the base. The collector section of the transistor is moderately doped, but larger in size, so that it can collect most of the charge carrier supplied by the emitter. Now, let's talk about transistor types. Transistors are divided into two types: bipolar junction transistors, also known as BJT, and field effect transistors, also known as FET. And that's not the end. Bipolar junction transistors are divided in NPN and PNP, while FET is divided into JFET and MOSFET. I know you are a little confused now, let's explain what they are and what their function is. Junction transistors are generally called as bipolar junction transistor. The term bipolar means both electrons and holes are required for conducting current, and the term junction means it contains PN junction, two junctions. In fact, the BJTs have three terminals named emitter, E, base, B, and collector, C. The BJT transistors are classified into NPN and PNP transistors depending on the construction. NPN is one of two types of bipolar junction transistors, BJT. NPN consists of two N-type semiconductor materials and they are separated by a thin layer of P-type semiconductor. Here, the majority charge carriers are electrons, while holes are the minority charge carriers. The flow of electrons is controlled by the current flow in the base terminal. The PNP is another type of bipolar junction transistors, BJT. The PNP transistors contain two P-type semiconductor materials and are separated by a thin layer of N-type semiconductor. The majority charge carriers in the PNP transistors are holes, while electrons are minority charge carriers. The arrow in the emitter terminal of transistor indicates the flow of conventional current. In PNP transistor, the current flows from emitter to collector. The field effect transistor, FET, is another major type of transistor. Basically, the FET also have three terminals, like BJTs. The three terminals are gate, drain, and source. Field effect transistor are classified into junction field effect transistors, JFET, and insulated gate field effect transistors, IGFET, or metal oxide semiconductor field effect transistors, MOSFET. The junction field effect transistor, JFET, is an earliest and simple type of field effect transistor. The JFETs are used as switches, amplifiers, and resistors. This transistor is a voltage-controlled device. It doesn't need any biasing current. The voltage applied between gate and source controls the flow of electric current between source and drain of the transistor. The JFET transistors are available in both N-channel and P-channel types. Metal oxide semiconductor field effect transistor, MOSFET, is most commonly used and most popular type of among all transistors. MOSFET has many advantages over BJT and JFET, mainly it offers high input impedance and low output impedance. It is used in switching and power circuits, and it is a main component on integrated circuit designing technologies. One of the major differences between the NPN and PNP transistor is that in the NPN transistor, the current flow between collector to emitter when the positive supply is given to the base, whereas in PNP transistor, the charge carrier flows from the emitter to collector when negative supply is given to the base. Transistors are used in amplifier circuits, radio, power regulator, controllers, phones, microprocessor, and computers. As we can see, they are widely used, and they are truly a revolutionary invention. The transistor was invented in 1947 by William Shockley, John Bardeen, and Walter Branton. It was the first type of transistor that could control a larger amount of power. It used a metal oxide semiconductor instead of a vacuum tube, which made it the smallest transistor ever created, only 1/8 inch long. We have come to the end of this video. If you liked it, please press like button and subscribe to the R channel. That help us keep posting educational videos.